Hello, good morning. Nice to greet you. This is the study of our English classes in the digital book, which you can find on this same social network. I invite you to subscribe, share, and comment.
Unit number 5, reported speech, commands, and requisites. Unit goals. In this unit, we will examine how to report commands. Okay, and for example, he told me to be here at 7 a.m. 7 o'clock. Other point, how to make requisites. Could you please tell me the time? Okay, other point, how to report requisites. And for example, she asked us not to smoke in the office. Okay, and how to express desires. I want you to arrive on time. And vocabulary. Report speech, commands, and requisites. And we have here the keywords and expression to annoy or annoying, to take time, to be around, to hold on, branch, and have better. And we have here the dialogue at the branch. Alina and Itzel are both teachers at the Zona Rosa branch of Interlingua. They both arrive a little before 3 o'clock. And Itzel say, "Hi, Alina, what are you doing here?" Alina say, "I was asked to substitute of class for Tere." And Itzel say, "Do you mean here 3 o'clock class?" She asked to me to substitute the same class. And Alina say, "They can't be right." Itzel say, "It's true. She even told me to ask the coordinator to cover all of her classes this afternoon." And Alina say, "I don't believe this. I don't have any other classes today. I wouldn't even be here if I didn't have to take this class." And Itzel say, "Well, when did she ask you to come in?" And Alina say, "She didn't. The coordinator called and told me to be here at 3 o'clock. Itzel say, "Well, I guess we'd better talk to Rafa. Then, hey, Rafa, did Tere ask you to find someone to cover her classes this afternoon?" And Rafa say, "Yeah, she asked me to cover her classes from 3 o'clock to 7:13. That's why I asked Alina to come in." And Itzel say, "But she asked me to do it." Rafa say, "I know, and I tried to talk to you this morning, but you had already left. I couldn't reach you. So I told Alina to take the classes." Itzel say, "But that's not fair." Rafa say, "Sorry, but there was nothing I called you. I needed to find someone right away, and you weren't around. I've told you not to arrange substitutes if you don't check with me first. Look, could you hold on for a minute? I need to take this call." And Itzel say, "Well, this is Anion." Alina say, "It sure is. If I call, I'd give you the class, but I took me 45 minutes. It's 45 minutes to get here. And if I didn't take to the class, it will all be for nothing." Itzel say, No, I couldn't ask you to do that. I guess I'll just go then. Rafa said, Itzel, hold on. Joaquin just called. He asked me to ask you to take the classes this afternoon. Itzel said, okay, I guess I call do that. And Rafa said, great, thank you a lot. Thanks a lot. Boy, I'm really glad you come in today. If you weren't here, I wouldn't have anyone to take those classes. And we have here to check your understanding with 5 questions. And the question number 1 is, what did Tere ask itself to do? Okay. Number 2, what did Tere tell Alima to ask the coordinator? Question number 3, why is Alina at the branch? Question number 4, what did the coordinator tell Alina to do? And question number 5, what did Joaquin ask the coordinator? This is the check understanding. And we have here the concept and the structure reminder. When we give a command in English, we use the verb in, and we have here a space, without a subject. And for example, check with me first. Check with me first. Okay? If we want to give a negative command, we use the auxiliary don't before the verb in simple form. And for example, don't arrange substitution yourselves. Okay? We have here the practice number 1, and we have here some important with concept and the structure number 1. And we want to report a command. We use told as our reporting verb, and the main verb is in the affirmative form. To and more the verb. We can report affirmative or negative commands. And we have here some examples. For example, he told them to check with him first. Okay? He told them not to arrange substitutions themselves. We have heard the subject, the told, the objective, the not, the verb, and in infinitive. Perfect. We have here the practice number 2, practice number 3, optional practice number 4, grammar capsule number 1, and here is important, with requisites. In many situations, simply giving a command will be considered rude or aggressive. In other, to soften the impact of something we want another person to do, we can instead make a request. Remember that a command a verb simple form. And for example, open the window. Open the window. To make an affirmative requisite, we simply add an expression before the command. Please open the window. Okay. All of the following expressions are said with a rising intonation, like a question. And for example, will you please open the window? Call you please. Open the window. Will you please open the window? Can you please open the window? Do you think you called? Please open the window. Okay. Notice that it is possible to add the word please to all expression if we are trying to be extra polite. For negative commands, there are fewer options for making a request. For this command, for example, don't smoke in here. Okay, don't smoke in here. We can simply add the word please. Please, don't smoke in here. We can also use this expression. Will you please not smoke in here? Okay, this is the grammar capsule number one. And we have here the practice number five. We have here some important with concept and the structure number two. When we want to report a requisite, we use asked as our reporting verb, and the main verb is in the infinite form, to and more the verb. We can report affirmative or negative requisites. And for example, she asked you to open the window. You asked us not to smoke in here. We have here the subject, asked, object, not, and verb in infinitive. This is for asked. She asked you to open the window. You asked us not to smoke here. Okay. We have here the grammar capsule number two, some important here. One, want someone to do something. When we want to express a desire for another person to do something, we can use the verb want with an object and an infinitive. For example, they want you to win. They want you to win. Okay. To express a negative desire, we use the verb want in negative. She doesn't want him to go. She doesn't want him to go. Okay? We can also use one in past to report a person's desire. In this case, we are talking about a person's desire for our feelings, even if they didn't actually make a command or requisite. And for example, they wanted here to win. Okay, they wanted here to win. The structure is similar to how we report commands and requisite with told and asked. However, the negative report with want is different. Instead of using the negative form of the infinitive, we use didn't want. We use didn't want and the regular infinitive. And for example, she didn't want him to go. Okay. We have here the practice number six, practice number seven, optional practice number eight, optional practice number nine, vocabulary review. Check your progress and notes. And this is all for this unit number five. Thank you very much, my friend, for listening this audio, for view this video. See you for the next time. Bye bye.
Financiero o financiera, un gusto saludarte. Mi nombre es Isaac Vadillo y en este espacio te voy a mostrar los diferentes productos, servicios bancarios. Yo soy Isaac Vadillo, tengo 9 años de carrera bancaria al día de hoy, año 2019, y quiero compartir contigo todo lo que he aprendido. El mundo bancario es bastante amplio y aquí te voy a compartir las diferentes herramientas, productos, servicios que pueden ser de tu utilidad. Bienvenido y que disfrutes este espacio.